I've been dressing up almost 21, 22 years to become a woman. And my desire is to be a woman. Hi, I'm Emmanuel. I was once a transgender. I'm a ex-transgender, which is I've been dressing up as a woman since my age 20. My journey last time, I always want to play with paper doll, masak-masak. I always steal my mother's pajamas and towels and make long hair and wear my mom's high heels and everything. When we were kids, we didn't know what is LGBT. Until my age of from 3, I started to know there's gay lifestyle. Then I started to say, hey, I think I am something different from everybody. So I behave very feminine all the time. I slowly go and do altering myself from a man body to become a woman's body. My lifestyle before is every weekends I have party. It's so tiring every weekends. You know why? You every day have to find clothes and look before you go out. It takes me 2 hours to 3 hours for me to dress up, to get myself prepared to meet people in the public, even though my neighbor or wherever. I may go out for half an hour, but I have to doll up like 2-3 hours. So my lifestyle is round and round, party, traveling, all this. So I was so tired. That's why that time I didn't know Jesus. I said, God, I'm so tired with this lifestyle. I think that is Jesus heard my prayer. I get connected with my old friends, my cell leader right now. She's journeying with me. I told her that time that we went fellowship at her house in the afternoon. I told her, I've been to Hinduism temple, I've been to Chinese temple, Siamese temple, whatever temple I go. I in fact go to mosque as well. But only place I never been is church. Since you are a Christian, I said, bring me to your church. The first thing I stepped into SIBKL church, I feel like, the presence of I'm home. I'm so welcome. Everyone is so friendly. Everyone is so nice. They treat me as who I am. They call me she that time. They did not call me he. As a transgender, a person they really want people to respect is, you call her she. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. That is my first song I want to hear when I go to church. But I don't see the needs of this song. So from there, I find that, okay, this is a very modern church. But I never been to any church. But this church, okay lah, take it lah. Then the message that the pastor James Cavalier said was so opened my eyes. That I didn't know that it's the generation curses from the bloodline and this thing and that. Even though I don't really understand, but I can catch what he's trying to say. He's from this background and everything. Wow, I say, wow, if this girl can change this man, I don't know what he's going to change if I'm asking anything. But I didn't ask her. There is a healing rally. My cell leader brought me there. But when they say sinner prayer, in my heart is my heart beat like want to drop like pop, 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 pop. Then after that, I say, okay, some voice tell me, hey, go and do sinner prayer. So I run up. Everyone was looking at me where I go. I just run out and say, okay, I accept Lord Jesus, you come take your way and come lead me and show me and tell me. I actually didn't tell them that I'm lost. The reason I believe this cell that I have right now is God put it on purpose to journey with me. As a ex-LGBT transgender, in 3 months' time, I started to feel that I become more masculine. I didn't realize that I was transformed by God until my cell group friends say that, hey, you change like more masculine, they could sell. Putting on makeups always is always very important to me, to doll up, to go out. But when you have Holy Spirit, He will lead you slowly, slowly. I cut my hair from shoulder length to a boy cut, from women's clothes to a t-shirt unisex, and then to a men's clothes, and from bit by bit, God's transformed me. Until this year, September, God asked me to remove my implant. Devil comes and steal and destroy and kill you, but Jesus come and give you life abundantly. And I think Jesus is restoring my identity. And God really protected me from all kind of sickness. I said, do you know, I only know relationship with men. I didn't know relationship with God. Until when I get to know, relationship with God is the best relationship that I ever had. Which is from there you can have the love that He pour into you is more than every other things that you want. If you have God's love, you can do everything. To me, ever since I know there's this God crisis, I will cling on it day and night. I'm so into everything. Without God, there's no me. If He can transform me, He can transform everybody.